Hey guys, this is Smot here, doing my Hydrophobia Prophecy review. Before I get into the meat of the review itself, I'd like to say a couple words about the developer of the game, and publisher as well, Dark Energy Digital. This game came out and they really weren't happy with the original version of the game, as I mentioned in the first video. So what they did is they took the time to actually come back, try to correct a lot of the problems they got complaints on from people who had bought the game, fix it, and resend it out. To me, that says a lot about this developer. They really do care about putting out a good product. A lot of developers would just say, oh, the game was substandard. Throw a couple quick patches for really easy things in there that really wouldn't cost any money to fix, real money to fix, and then mothball the game, move on to the next thing, and try to make money. What Dark Energy Digital did is they said, essentially said, this isn't right. We want to make a good game. We're proud of our product. So they went back and they redid it. So I got to give a lot of props to them. It takes a lot to admit your game was flawed, and it takes great character, on behalf of that company to go back and care enough about making a good product and giving the people who purchased their product what they feel is a good game. So with that out of the way, I want to move into the actual review of the game itself. I want to discuss the bad things first. The controls were quirky at times. I would go to crouch behind something to take cover, and you wouldn't have the cover there where appropriate, or it wouldn't work. Other times the same spot would work just fine. So that was one thing that kind of was a drawback there with the game, for the game to me. Another thing is there were some bugs. There were parts like near the end where there was a video on the wall explaining like part of the story. The actors were acting it out, but there was no audio to go with it. And it's right near like kind of the end of the story where they have this guy captured or whatnot, and it really detracted from the game trying to follow the story, and that video didn't play. It's kind of to me, that's a big thing. Also, aim down the sight was sometimes bugging out. I would try to aim down the sight, nothing would happen multiple times. Also, I did have a crash of the game, so that is also kind of a bug. It was annoying. I ran through two or three minutes of an area before a checkpoint, and with the checkpoints in this game, they save. You don't have actually save games; it actually saves on your disc, so it saves as you move along. And I lost all that progress, plus the game crashed. So that was kind of annoying. Also, enemies getting stunned is not apparently obvious. You shoot a guy, he's blinking on the ground, right? I figure that means the guy is dead. However, I guess in this game that means the guy is just stunned, he's incapacitated, he's not dead. They just get back up and start shooting at you. That was annoying sometimes. Also, that goes with that, and the enemies getting stunned, there were like a lot of these spawns that were kind of frustrating at times. I understand when you throw a switch, maybe, or complete, like, a task in that area, you might get some backspawns, but these, they seem to spawn at different points, and that was kind of frustrating. You know where they were going to come from? They'd backspawn you, or you'd run by something. I would just be there out of nowhere. That was kind of annoying at times. Also, the camera angles at times, this kind of goes with the controls, but the camera angles, you would surface, and the camera would spin all over the place, and that was kind of annoying. That could be better done, in my opinion. Also, I did have a couple minor performance issues. I generally wouldn't ding a game for performance issues if it was only in a couple areas, but I did get a lot of, well, not I would say a lot of, but there were a good number of spots where, it just felt laggy, and I could forgive it if my computer wasn't like, an extremely quick computer. But my computer is pretty fast for the most part. The graphics card is a little, it's not old-ish, like not old and out of date. It's not the strongest card, but I did have the game reduced to 720p resolution. Most settings are on high, some are on medium, but the resolution, really was the big thing. If I was running it full HD with everything maxed out, I could see where a game might at times have problems with my graphics card. And if you're curious what it is, it's a GTX 460. My full system is in one of my first videos, so if you're looking for that information, you can go check that out. Also, at the end, kind of in the middle of the game, the gameplay started to get repetitive. Same enemies, only the one set of enemies. So I'd like to see a little bit more there. The game was short, but considering the cost, it's still pretty good value. I wouldn't knock it on the campaign of around, I don't know, 3.5-4 hours or so, which is pretty good actually, considering the cost of the game. Or most AAA titles, as they're called, or big budget titles, you get maybe a 4 to 8 hour campaign. This title is around $10, and I picked up for $3 on Steam on sale. It's still a 4 hour campaign, so value for the money there was good, even though that was short. That kind of segues into the good, because that's a half good, half bad thing. Okay, so now I want to get into the good of the game. I thought the water physics in this game were very good to outstanding. They had a lot of, the water actually had kind of real physics. As the water level rose, your character actually was progressively affected by it. That was a pretty cool thing I haven't seen in the game before. The movement of the water also was really cool, how it would actually rush around things, and almost like it was kind of exaggerated compared to real water, of course, but it was still very good. The physics looked a lot more realistic than I've ever seen any other game. So the water engine they have, I guess that's why they call it Hydrophobia, but they have this awesome water engine. The water engine in this game is very, very good. That's definitely a plus, stands out above any title I can think of offhand. Also, another thing that was kind of cool to kind of go with the water thing was the water control at the end of the game. I thought it was a pretty cool and creative thing. I haven't seen that before, where the character actually controlled the water and moved it around like that. Maybe it's another game, I don't know, but I haven't seen it. So that was pretty cool. They also used it for solving some puzzles. And also the end boss, but they also use it for solving some puzzles, like where I had to move the giant crates to make a bridge. I thought that was pretty cool. I actually would have liked to see the water powers introduced earlier, and it used more extensively in the game. I thought it was a really, really cool concept. From my understanding, this game is supposed to be, I guess, maybe a three-part series, like Hydrophobia 1, 2, and 3, I guess. So hopefully in the second part, we will see more use of this, ability to move water and maybe solving some puzzles with it. The gameplay from the last, 20 or 30 minutes of it, 30 minutes or so after you got that power, I thought the gameplay was really good. I really enjoyed it. Okay, so now I'd like to give the game a total rating. I'd like to give it actually disappointing, but I'd like to say around a 5.5, just because of the bugs and the quirky controls and the camera angles and the gameplay that kind of got repetitive after the beginning section throughout the middle. So I'm going to deduct pretty heavily on that. One thing I would like to say is I am going to be looking into more games, or looking for the follow-up for this game from this developer. As I mentioned at the start, I really do like the fact this developer did try to put out the best product they could. They cared about the game and actually did a lot of after release work from the original copy. To me, that shows a lot of integrity. So I will be looking into their future products, despite this game only getting a 5.5 on my score rating. The value for the money was there as well. It was a 3.5-4 hour campaign. I paid $3 for the game, even full price at $10. It's probably worth that. So value for the game, even though it was somewhat lower rating, if you can get by the quirky controls and whatnot, it was fun. It had some cool physics, and it's probably worth buying just to see the physics engine alone for the water. It was really cool. So hopefully the next game they come out with, they can maybe use some of that water control more, put some more creative puzzles in there, and come out with what I would consider much better game if they can also clean up the controls to be better. It would end up being a really solid game at that point, something worthy of a much higher rating. Thanks for watching my review and playthrough. Hopefully this gives you some insight on the game, lets you know if you're interested in purchasing and playing it yourself. And as always, thanks for watching. See you next time.